Hello friends, welcome to Exam Tricks. This video is first part of the series covering the topic climate from unit 4 of NCERT class 11. This unit contains 5 chapters and there will be 5 videos for each chapter. The first video covers atmosphere, composition and structure. Second one will cover insulation. Third one will cover pressure belts, winds, planetary, seasonal, etc. Fourth one would cover precipitation, and the fifth one would cover world climates. In this way, we will cover all the chapters of the unit climate and also try to cover remaining units so that revising NCERT would be simpler for you. Since we know that for the subject geography, NCERT of class 11 and 12 are the most important books. So, let us move forward to our first chapter, atmosphere, composition and structure. First of all, what is atmosphere? Atmosphere is a mixture of different gases which envelops the earth all around, and 99% of the total mass of the earth of the atmosphere is confined to the height of 32 km from the earth's surface. Now, composition of the atmosphere. We know that atmosphere is composed of gases, water vapor and dust particles. The four important gases of the atmosphere are nitrogen, oxygen, argon and carbon dioxide. This importance is on the basis of amount of the gases present in the air. Since in the atmosphere nitrogen is 78.08%, oxygen is 20.9%, argon is 0.93, carbon dioxide is 0.036. You need not to remember the exact figure, but at least you should have in your mind few important things, such as the percentage of argon is more than carbon dioxide, and presence of hydrogen is least among the gases. You can remember the gases in the descending order by forming any sentence. For example, I have formed here one sentence: no AC in the new house. In this sentence, N is for nitrogen, O is for oxygen. In the AC, A is for argon, C is for carbon dioxide. New NE is for neon. In the house, H is for helium. You can form your own sentence. Now, some important facts related to these gases are, first, that oxygen will be almost negligible quantity at the height of 120 km. Second, carbon dioxide and water vapor are found only up to 90 km from the surface of the earth. Third, ozone is found between 10 and 50 km above the earth's surface, mainly in the stratosphere. Fourth, carbon dioxide is transparent to the incoming solar radiation but opaque to the outgoing terrestrial radiation, and for this reason carbon dioxide is called greenhouse gas because it traps the solar radiation which radiates from the heated earth. Another important fact worth remembering is that water vapor decreases with altitude. It also decreases from the equator towards the poles. Dust particles are also part of the atmosphere, and the higher concentration of dust particle is found in the subtropical and temperate regions due to dry winds in comparison to equatorial and polar regions. These were the 6 important facts in the first page of the chapter. Now let us move to the structure of the atmosphere. The atmosphere can be divided and is divided into 5 layers. These are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere. This image here shows the vertical arrangement of the different layers of the atmosphere. The first layer of the atmosphere, or the lowermost layer, is troposphere, and its average height is 13 km, but it extends from height 8 km near the poles to 18 km at the equator. It is more thick at the equator because of the heat which transports it to greater heights. This layer contains all the dust particles and water vapor, and all the changes in the weather take place at this level. Here, temperature decreases at the rate of 1 degree centigrade for every 165 meter of height. it decreases up to minus 80 degree centigrade and then become constant. This is called tropopause. This zone separates the troposphere from stratosphere. After this tropopause begins the layer stratosphere. The stratosphere extends then up to a height of 50 km, and in this layer we can find the ozone layer, the one of the most important layer which protects us from ultraviolet rays. Above the stratosphere we have the mesosphere, which extends up to a height of 80 km. Here again temperature decreases with height. The upper limit of mesosphere is known as the mesopause. After this mesopause, the layer ionosphere starts, which extends between 80 and 400 km above the mesopause. It contains electrically charged particles known as ions, and hence it is known as ionosphere. Radio waves transmitted from the earth are reflected back to the earth by this layer. Finally, the exosphere is the uppermost layer of the atmosphere above the thermosphere, about which we do not have much information. With this, the first part, atmosphere composition and structure, is concluded. I hope this video would help you in revising the whole chapter in just 5 to 6 minutes. I will be uploading all the remaining videos of this unit, climate. Hope you like this video. Thanks for watching.